we're at Curry Planet again. There's Ami. It's been a while since she's been in the vlog. I got the Kima curry. She got the lamb curry. Itadakimasu. Thank you.
Cheers. It is so delicious.
What is with these cars?
What is this? What is all this? I can't barely even drive this car, and then... What is this stuff? This is amazing. Oh my god. Like, what is this supposed to be? Fox Sports Ethical Meeting? What? I don't know what this is, but this is amazing.
Welcome back to another rousing segment of Going to the Konbini Late at Night. It is currently... I cannot tell. It is currently... 12:30 at night. I have the choice of going to the Konbini or going to the Life, the Life store, the supermarket. I'm just straight up flat out hungry. I don't know why I don't have enough snacks in my apartment, because I guess I just buy snacks at the Konbini for this segment, right?
It appears as though they're out of my favorite traditional Japanese snack, which is this. Nori wrapped rice cracker. That is one of my favorite things ever.
It is seriously just really delicious. It's like sometimes they have a little bit of wasabi flavor. Ooh, it's so good, but they don't have any anymore.
Never mind, I found it. Here we go, Shinagawa-maki. I love it. I'm gonna issue a formal complaint to all snack makers everywhere. You see this bag? That's all air. The rest of it, half of it's snack, half of it's air. Don't do that. Ooh, chocolate marshmallows. Okay, I'm gonna get these. Maybe. Oh, there's actually food in here. Now for some tea. And there we go. Successful trip to the Konbini late at night.
I'm gonna make this a regular segment on the show just because I'm always really hungry late at night. I really just stopped giving a shit about a diet, right? I feel kind of sad. The Rugby World Cup's over, all the rugby fans left. There's no games to look forward to this weekend and go to the pub to watch. I miss it. I'm looking forward to the Olympics now, but I wish there was more stuff to watch, you know. That sense of camaraderie of everyone going to the pub and just watching any sort of game, really. It's something I missed from Ohio, it's something I missed from Arizona, because I would go to B-dubs all the time and watch hockey there in Phoenyx. I mean, I got a nice feeling from that when I went to the baseball game earlier this year with Ami, but like, people don't really get together at pubs and restaurants and stuff to watch sports, right? And now it's off-season for a lot of sports here in Japan, so I'm hoping rugby picks up in population as the series is set to kick off sometime soon. I forgot when the series starts, but I'm gonna try to go to a few of those games live, like the actual Japanese rugby league games, or not rugby league, rugby union league. How do you call it? The top level of Japanese rugby union, right? I'm gonna go see those live because that looks like a lot of fun. Can't wait to see it, but it's like I gotta figure out how to get there. But in the meantime, I just miss all the stuff happening here, you know? That was a lot of fun. That was just so much fun. I just left the supermarket in my bag of whatever here. Let me show you. Got a bag of chocolatey cereal. I had a coupon to get a, I think, 50 yen discount. And the Yuko Kigen of that coupon, which is the expiry date, I don't know the name of the freaking thing. I don't speak English anymore. Was today, November 5. Now, while editing this vlog for you guys, for your enjoyment, my iMac decided to take a shit and die. I hope you guys appreciate my videos because it is frustrating as all hell when that thing dies. So, when it died, I was like, okay, deep breath. Exhale. I'm gonna go down the street, get some snacks, watch some anime once this thing boots back up. If they wasn't gonna take that freaking coupon, I was prepared to go all Karen on them bitches, because you know what? That is not the shit I need to hear while I'm done. Computer dies while editing a video. Yeah. But no, luckily enough, coupon worked. I saved 50 yen, which is junk change at this point. And now I'm walking home to watch anime and eat snacks like a total 28-year-old scrub that I am, right? I've never seen such a long line for the Singapore chicken. I don't know what's happening here. I forgot the golden rule of Ginza, the golden rule of Tokyo. If you want to be somewhere and you know when that thing opens, you got to be there at opening, because otherwise you're going to be, yeah.
5 minutes later, you place your order and then you wait in the second line to get your food, so you know. Line still hasn't really gone down, it's just transferred sides.